A lot of healers are getting some kind of tank healing. So there's druids are getting stuff. Monks are getting that increased healing boost thing. Currently, I believe currently they're getting it from like all sources of healing. Like they boost all sources of healing that target receives. But in the future, people are speculating that it's going to be only the druid. I don't know. Or only the monk that'll benefit from the increased healing, but at the moment I believe it's everybody unless they've changed it. So having your whatever the mists is that increases the healing taken with the set bonuses, that's going to be awesome, especially if you have druids with their double life blooms or you have paladins with double beacon and the double beacon buff that they're getting. So monks are going to be strong, and that's going to be a nice bit of I guess utility that they're also getting. So looks nice. I'm kind of worried about Holy Priest, to be honest. The type of damage that would, or the thing about discs that would nerf disc per se at this point, since they're not going to do any nerfs at the moment, is definitely going to be, it's going to have to be something along the lines of like the type of damage on the encounters. So if it's like very high steady damage or something like that, you know, then that would kind of weaken them. But at the moment, I mean, they don't look like they're getting amazing stuff. But they're not getting horrible stuff either, so compared to like 25 flat percent increase of your beacon healing, which is ridiculous. And currently with the Holy Pally set bonus, the 4 set, it works off of all your beacon transfers. So literally you're just gonna have the 6-8% haste no matter what, unless they fix that. So there's no interaction, you just get a flat good amount of haste. I think Pally's really come out in really good shape, even with the Holy Shock nerfs. It's gonna require us to have a lot more spirit. Like, I think you're gonna need 400 to 600 more spirit. So if you have like the Chew Toy, for instance, in Blackrock Foundry, and you have like a flat int trinket or something like that, or you have the Gorn Soul Repository, which are more or less your progression best in slot, you're gonna wanna switch the Chew Toy for a spirit trinket of some sort, so like the Black Hand spirit one, or the Black Hand Spirit one, or the Blast Furnace one. Preferably the Black Hand one. But one of those just to get that extra spirit, so. In that aspect, once you kind of catch up with the spirit, it's also a little bit of negative synergy with your set bonus, where you're going to have to, if you're going with more and more spirit, you're going to be, or if you're going with more and more haste, rather, from your set bonuses, it's going to make your Holy Shock usage increase. So that's going to be another thing that you have to account for, just needing more and more mana. But with no changes really to Holy Radiance, they're really not going to be using Holy Radiance very much, at least not in progression. Because it's just going to be so expensive, and you're already stretching your mana so hard, you know? So, speculation, not going to use it a lot. Holy Pally is going to be strong. It's still going to be strong. Double Holy Pally is going to be weakened, though, because you're not going to need that much beacon absorbs. Like, once you started getting your paladins, like, extremely well geared, you know, it's just starting to get massive overheal, you know? So, I think that's going to continue, especially with two set bonuses. So, if you have double Holy Pally, that comp's a little bit weaker because of that. And I think it's going to kind of reward you for more. But there's also, on the other hand, like, paladins are also getting Devo with any kind of damage, so that's huge as well. So you kind of got to balance that. Like, paladins still bringing insane raid utility, so no. The one that I'm worried is getting quote-unquote worse, like, because they're bringing everybody up, obviously, they're buffing everybody, but one that I'm kind of concerned that they're not really buffing enough is Holy Priest. If anything, we're losing out on our set bonuses a little bit. The haste is okay. It's kind of whatever, because it's not going to be that great if Renew's not that great. Because, you know, there's a bunch of fights in Blackrock Foundry. There's a good amount of fights in Blackrock Foundry where haste or Renew spamming is really not that good. It comes to mind like Thogar or Iron Maidens. What else? Thogar, Iron Maidens. There's other burst damage fights. I'm trying to remember the other one that comes to mind. But you guys know what I mean. When you get into those fights where there's so much burst damage to it, and you're just like, wow, there's no way in hell I'm going to be, renew spamming super effectively, you kind of turn to more clarity of, or more circle heal use, and that brings you up. You know, that's why so many people are running with a circle heal glyph these days. So, if there's not enough constant heavy damage fights, like Chromog or Blast Furnace or those kind of fights, or Black Hand, where there's just constant steady damage going on the raid, which super favors your hots, you know, then the haste is going to be pretty devalued. At the moment, with your current 4-step bonus, Mastery is pulling ahead of haste, so... But you're also losing out on the Serendipity stacks that you once had, which really sucks. And if anything, the split-off for Holy Priest that you have, where it's like your palm will split, is worse than having those extra stacks of palm that you have currently. So, there's that.
Is this near side?
But the haste is solid, you know? The haste is good. What's up, Truth? How's it going, dude? So I feel like you're getting a good 2-set and a crappy 4-set, and our class trinket is god-awful, honestly. Yeah. At the moment, it's god-awful. It could really be good. It could really, really be good if they change the Holy Priest, the chakra requirement and the cast requirement. Because those two things, like, we could be casting single-target heal on people like a paladin does, but... When we're being punished to do it, like the mana cost is whatever, because heal's very cheap.
I'm not going up, you're selling.
Okay.
Heal's just really cheap, which is fine. So the mana cost increased is fine. But the cast speed is like killer. And the chakra requirement is also killer. So. Did you? Good shit, dude. That's awesome. The cool paladin one, if only. It's basically a copy pasta of set bonuses in Siege of Orgrimmar. Honestly. But slide!
Soak the one on top of the raid. Jack, solo that one.
Let's go, baby. We'll go more in depth. Remind me about this to do this, to talk about it after.
Oh, fuck.
But I need to kill some bosses.
Two people said middle. I got Peon and I can get a lump. Say, oh.
Falling to breed 9 seconds. Get ready.
So let's go.
Falling to breed.
Beware.
I got this.
Five. Nice shot, guys.
We need to move again. We need to move. Right.
Yep. Move, 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 move. Get out of there.
Beware. Moving a bit more after this. Right here. Found it.
All right, baby.
Okay, Ray, move. I'm looking.
Push it, push it.
It's the limit.
Grab it.
So what's going on, baby?
Away from that.
Just gotta not fuck this up.
Oh, shit, those marks.
Find clean space.
Get.
Oh my gosh.
Kill this fucker.
Bumped out. 4, 3, 2, 1.
Fuck you.
Ow, ow! Yes! Let's go!
I wish I had a coin.
Fucking did it.
Nice, guys.
Yeah, good stuff.
Yes!